हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो लेट्स बिगिन विथ द सम बेस्ड ऑन द टाइप नंबर टू। एज इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी सॉ द कॉन्सेप्ट बेस्ड ऑन द टाइप नंबर टू। एज आई टोल्ड दैट टाइप नंबर टू इट इज बेस्ड ऑन द स्टेटमेंट सम। एज इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी सॉ द बेसिक थिंग्स, द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ योर 11th स्टैंडर्ड एज वेल एज द concept based on 12th also. As I told, the type number 2, it is based on this formula. It is called as binomial distribution. I had explained each and everything about the term, how to guess the value of n, p, q, x from the given question. I had explained about the Bernoulli trials also. What do you mean by Bernoulli trials? Then after that, we saw the formula in which I had explained each and everything about the terms. Then I told that in this chapter, permutation, combination, and this factorial, this exclamatory mark, actually it is known as factorial. This factorial and combination part will play an important role while solving the sum. So in the last lecture we did the sums based on the combination and we saw the formulas also, and I had explained about the factorial also. What do you mean by factorial? And I told that this combination formula, it will play an important role. There are some formulas based on combination. As in the previous lecture only, I had explained each and everything about this. Okay, and then after that we saw about exactly, at least, and at most. When it comes in the question, how to solve? When it is exactly, exactly means x equals to, exactly means equal to. At least means what? Greater than equal to. At most means what? Less than equal to. So this all things, small things, you have to remember, because while solving the sum, this all the concept will come. And I had shown the shortcut method also, in case if you want to find like at least x greater than equals to 2. That means if you want to find 2, 3, 4, 5, instead of solving 2, 3, 4, 5, simply what you have to do, find 0 and 1 and subtract with 1. Okay. So this part, this combination part, will play an important role. And I had explained two methods to solve the combination part. Either you can solve the answer by using formula, you can find your answer by using formula, or else I'd explain one shortcut method also. Okay, so without knowing the concept, the basic things of this combination and the factorial, you cannot start with the sums. And please don't dare to start with the sums of the exercise without knowing the concept of factorial and combination. And here I had given each and everything, how to guess that particular number, it is a value of n, that particular number, it is a value of p, and after getting the value of p, simply substitute the value of p here, you will get the value of q. X means what? To find. And remember this, the value of x, it will always start from 0 only, 0 comma 1 comma 2, and then goes on. And for n, remember, whenever the word comes in the statement, some outcomes, times, drawn, okay, items, consist, brought, it means it is a value of n. Whenever the word comes probability, success, percentage, or else in place of percentage, they will use this symbol. It means it is a value of p. Okay, as you will get the value of p, simply apply this formula, q equals to 1 minus p, or p plus q equals to 1, to get the answer of q. Okay, and remember, without knowing this factorial and combination, you cannot start with your sums. And this all things actually it was there in the 11th standard, but in the last lecture I had explained each and everything about the combination and the factor also. So let's begin with the sums of the type number 2, sums based on statement sums. Okay, so let's check the first example. As here the first example is what? It says that a die is thrown. A die means what? It is a dice only. Okay, a die is thrown. A die means a single die is thrown. How many times? 6 times. How many times? 6 times. As I explained in the last lecture that whenever the word comes, outcomes, times, drawn in a statement sum, straight away that particular number you have to consider as a value of n. So here can I say here the value of n, clearly we can see that it is n equals to 6. Yes or no? If getting an odd number, a dice is thrown, a die is thrown 6 times, that means straight away here we can say the value of n is 6. If getting an odd number is a success, here clearly it is mentioned that a successful part we have to consider as an odd number and the failure part as an even number. And here we know that the successful part is known as P and failure part it is known as Q. So here we'll consider P as getting an odd numbers. Understood? Then you have to find the probability of 5 successes. Second part is what? At least 5. And the third one is what? At most 5. So here the first one it says that 5 successes, that means 5, it means this 5 is without the word at least and at most, at the most. Okay, it means whenever the number comes without at least, yeah, at most, it means it is known as exactly. Actually it is known as what? Exactly. Okay, remember this. So actually this 5 successes means exactly 5 we have to find. At least 5 means what? So what do you mean by at least? It means greater than equal to 5. At most means less than equals to 5. Exactly 5 means what? Equal to 5. So here clearly we can see that we have to find the probability. As I told, the finding part is what? It is x. So first, in the first question we have to find the answer for x equals to 5. In the second question we have to find the answer for x greater than equals to 5. And in the third one we have to find the answer for x less than equals to 5. So let's begin with the presentation part. So first step, you will write what? Let x denote the number of odd numbers. So let's x denote the number of odd numbers. Now we'll consider P as a successful trials. That means here clearly mentioned that we have to consider successful as odd number and failure as the even number. So here we'll consider P as getting an odd number. Yes or no? Getting an odd numbers. So that means this is a successful trial and Q is known as failure. So therefore the value of small p will be equal to what? Now we'll see how to find the probability of getting an odd number. Now here no need of writing the sample space, no need of writing n of a, no need of writing n of a. Okay, directly you can write the answer of probability of getting an odd number. Okay, now simply I will explain the sum here. As dice is thrown 6 times. Okay, in each and every trial, suppose a die is thrown one time. So what will be the sample space? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, we'll consider A as a odd number. Okay, so when you will see the sample space, there are 6. N of A will consider as an odd number. How many odd numbers are there? 1, 2, 3. So here we can say 3. So we'll find the probability of getting an odd number. So the formula is what? N of A upon N of S. So here we can say 3 by 6. So answer will be 1 upon 2. Yes or no? So if I repeat the experiment for the several times, like 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, or several times, okay, the successful probability will be same only. The value of P in each and every trial, it will be same. It will be 1 by 2 only. So, you have no need of showing the sample space and of A, no need of writing this all 3-4 steps here. Directly you can mention, directly you can write the value of P as you will get out of 6 sample space, there will be 3 odd numbers. So, the answer will be 1 by 2. So, using the formula of P plus Q equals to 1, so 1 by 2 plus Q equals to 1. So Q will be equals to 1 minus 1 by 2. So therefore Q will be equals to, this will be what, 1 by 2 only. So here we got the value of P as well as Q also. And we know that the value of N is what? 6. Yes or no? Understood? Okay. So now, after that, for each and every sum, you will write this step as capital X. Okay, the similar symbol. Then you will write B, it is known as binomial distribution. Then N equals to 6 and P equals to 1 by 2. For each and every sum, you will write this step. Okay, you will get half mark for this part. It means what? If you want to find the value of X, okay, by using the binomial distribution, if you want to find the value of X, it's the value of X is all depend upon what? The value of N and P. If you have the value of N and P, after P you will get Q. Okay. And if you have these three values, N, P, Q, and X is what to find, simply substitute the value, you will get the answer for to find whether it is at least, at the most, or for exactly. Okay, so remember this. Okay, so here for each and every sum you have to mention this step, don't forget. It means what? X, it depend on the value of N and P. If you have the value of N and P, easily we can find the value of X by using binomial distribution. Okay, now so you have no need of showing this part, it's a rough work. So we'll see what is the first one here. 5. That means 5 successes means what? Exactly 5. Before that, you will write the formula. Okay. The formula is what? P X equals to small x, that is equals to N Cx into P of X into Q raised to N minus X. Okay. First you will write the formula. Then after that, one by one, you will find your answer. Okay, so this formula actually it is known as probability mean function of x, or else we can say it is binomial distribution formula also. Okay, so after this step, in each and every sum, after this step you will mention the formula, and then after that you will start finding the answer one by one. So here the first one is what? Phi successes, that means, it means what? We have to find the probability of x equals to phi. Okay, so whenever the word comes exactly, that means you have to apply the formula only for one time. Okay, so now first we'll find the answer for p x equals to phi. So therefore we'll write p x equals to phi. So I replace this x equals to x by x equals to phi. Now no need of writing the formula here, just simply substitute the value. What is n? That is 6. Then you will write c. What is x, which you have to find, that is 5. Okay, what is the value of p? That is 1 by 2. What is x? That is 5. What is q? It is 1 by 2. N minus x. N minus x means what? 6 minus 5. Okay, as we know that 6c5 we can find using two method, one by using formula method or by using shortcut method. So what do you mean by the shortcut method here? Okay, so here, as I explained in the previous video, this part, this number, it is known as the number of items, and this part is known as the selection part. For the selection part, we'll write the answer as 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. I hope so you all might be knowing how to solve this combination part. Now for 6, what I will do from 6, okay, you will write the number, you will in backward direction, okay, as the selection part is what? 5, na? So 6, 5, 4, so you have to select only 5 numbers from 6. So 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, okay, once again, for this selection part, this I will use here the denominator, okay, this 5, you will write in the denominator from 5, you will write 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, up to 1 you will write. For this part, okay, for 6, number of items, just check the selection number. How many numbers you have to select? 5. From 6, you have to select only 5 numbers in backward direction. So the answer will be 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. After this, into, here it is 1 upon 2. And this, when you will solve, 1 upon 2, 6 minus 5. 1 upon 2 raised to 5 into 1 upon 2, 6 minus 5 is what? 1. Okay. So when you will solve this part, you will get what? 5, 4, 5, 5, and 4, 4 will get cancelled. 3, 2 also. So here we left with 6 upon 1. Okay. So this 1 upon 2 raised to 5 into 1 upon 2 raised to 1. Can I write this step as 1 upon 2 raised to 6? Yes, when you will see this part, it is in the form of a raised to m into a raised to n, which we can write as a raised to m plus n. So here a is what? 1 by 2, so 1 upon 2, and m plus n. So when it is into, so we'll write what? M plus n. So 5 plus 1 will be what? 6. So 1 raised to 6 will be 1, and this will be 2 raised to 6 only. Yes or no? Okay. So 1 upon 2 raised to 5 into 1 upon 2 raised to 1. This we can write as 1 upon 2 raised to 5 plus 1 is what? 6. 1 raised to 6 is 1, and 2 raised to 6, I wrote 2 raised to 6 only. After that, I will keep this 6 as it is, and 6 1 is 6. 1 into 2 raised to 6 is 2 raised to 6. After this, 2 raised to 6 is more what? 2 2 we have to multiply 6 times. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. So what will be the answer? 2 2 is 4, 4 2 is 8, 8 2 is 16, 16 2 is 32, 32 2 is 64. Now check, can we cancel this 2 number? Yes, we can cancel this number by 2. 2 3 is 6, 2 3 is and 2 2 is. So here we got 3 by 32. After this, I guess we cannot cancel the number further. So here we got the answer. As you cannot cancel the number further, so that means it is the end of the sum. So here we got the answer for exactly 5. The answer is 3 upon 32. You can divide this number. You will get the answer in 0 point something, okay? Or you can keep your answer in fraction also. When you will see the backside answer, your backside answer, it is in fraction, I guess, okay? So you can keep your answer in fraction also, or else you can divide the answer. When you will divide the answer, see to it that up to 4 decimal place you have to find your answer. That means 0 point up to 4 decimal place, okay? But I guess your backside answer, it is in fraction only. So here we got the answer for the first one for 5 successes. That means it known as what? Exactly 5. Now in the second part, we'll see how to find the answer for at least 5 and at most 5. Okay, so you have to remember this part. You will start with let, then you will find p. After finding the p, you will find q by using this formula, that is p plus q equals to 1. Okay, for each and every sum, remember you have to show this two step, this part and the formula part. After that, you will start finding the answer one by one. As we completed with the first one, first part, now we'll see how to find the answer for at least 5. And then after that, for at most 5. Okay. Okay, so now here, instead of finding 6C5 using this, we can apply this formula, this one. As I had explained in the previous video, the 6C5 I can write as what? 6C. 6 minus 5 will be what? 1. Okay. So instead of 6C5, you can find 6C. You can write 6C1 in the next step. And this part same. Okay. Still you will get the same answer. It is on you. Okay. You can apply the formula method to find the answer, or else you can apply the method directly. And if you feel that the number, it is closer to this number, then apply this formula, reduce the value and then find the answer. Understood? I hope you all might be knowing how to solve the combination part, okay, and even the factorial also. But I will suggest to solve the combination part without using the formula method. Means this is known as the direct method without using formula method. This is known as without using the formula method. Okay. And remember, you can keep your answer in fraction also, as in the backside answer. When you will see each and every sum, the backside answer, it is in fraction only. Okay. So now we'll see the second part. For at least, okay. So the second one is what? At least 5. It means what? P x greater than equals to 5. That means we have to find the probability of at least 5. That at least 5, it is a value of x only, na? Yes or no? So therefore, p x greater than equals to 5, it means what? So the values will be what? After 5, it will be 6. Okay, at least 5. Greater than equals to means what? You have to consider 5 also. So the value will be 5 and 6. Okay. So you will get p of 5 plus you will write and then p of 6. Okay, now as I explained in the previous video, you can apply the shortcut method also. For the shortcut method, when you will apply the shortcut method for this, okay, you will write 1 minus x negation of this. Negation of this is what? Less than 5. So it means 1 minus less than 5 will be what? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. It says that less than 5, so you cannot write 5. If it is less than equal to, then you have to mention 5 also. Now remember, for this sum, if you are applying the shortcut method, this formula, this one, okay, here when you will see how many values are the 1 2 3 4 5, so that means you have to apply the formula, okay, binomial formula, this one, 5 times. Okay, so in the first, when you will apply the formula for the first time, you will get for p of 0, means when you will replace the value of x by 0, you will get for p of 0. When you will replace the value of x by 1, you will get for p of 1. Okay, that means we have to apply the formula for 5 times. Okay, and here you have to apply the formula only for 2 times. At least means what? 5 or more than 5. Okay, so 5, 6, we can write the 7 also, 8 also, but remember till where we have to write, till the value of n. First you have to check the value of n. For this sum, the value of n is what? For this sum, the value of n is what? 6. So up to 6 you will write. Okay, so when you will apply the shortcut formula for this, clearly we can see that a shortcut formula is not applicable. If you apply also, you will get, in both the cases you will get the same answer only. But remember, here you have to apply the formula for 5 times and here only for 2 times. Okay, in both the cases you will get the same answer. So that now you have to guess when we have to apply the shortcut method or when to not. Okay, so here we have to apply the formula only for 2 times. Okay, when you will apply this formula, so here you have to apply the formula for 5 times. So now it is on you. Okay, in both the cases you will get the same answer. Okay, so but remember, in majority of the sum, this shortcut will play an important role. For this sum, I guess, okay, this part is flop, I can say. So we'll stick with a proper way only, not with the shortcut method. So for now, as here in the first sum we saw how to find the value for p x equals to 5. It means actually what, this can be written as p of 5 also. The meaning of x equals to 5 and p of 5, it means one and the same. Understood? So now we'll apply the formula. As the formula is what, as I wrote the formula here, no need of writing the formula for each and every part while finding the first one, while finding the second one. Just write the formula only one time, okay, and then simply substitute the value. As for 5 will apply ncx, so here the value of n is what? 6c. The value of x is what? 5. P is what? 1 by 2. X is what? 5, 1 by 2, n minus x, matlab 6 minus 5, yes or no? Directly you can write this step, 6 minus 5 is what? 1. Okay, so here in the next part, the value of x is what? 6. So here we can write as what? 6c6 into p is what? 1 by 2, the value of x, now here it is what? This is known as actually x only, okay? Because as I told, p x equals to x can be written as p of x also. Okay, then p raised to x, so here x is 6, 1 by 2, n minus 6, so here n is what? 6, x is also 6. So the next step, this can be written as सिक्स इंटू फाइव इंटू फोर इंटू थ्री इंटू टू. ओके, वी हैव टू सेलेक्ट ओनली फाइव नंबर फ्रॉम सिक्स एंड दिस वी कैन राइट इज वॉट फाइव इंटू फोर इंटू थ्री इंटू टू इंटू वन. अंडरस्टूड? नाउ 1 by 2 raised to 5 and this 1 by 2 raised to 6 minus 1. So 1 by 2 raised to 5, 1 by 2 raised to 6 minus 5 is what? 1. And 6, 6, 6. So this part will be what? 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. From 6, we have to select the 6 number. So 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We want one more number. 1 by 2 raised to 6. We'll keep this step as it is. 1 by 2 raised to 6 minus 6 is what? 0. Now see the calculation part here. How to solve in a tricky way. So this we can cancel 5, 4, 3, 2. So we left with 6 upon 5. When you will see this part, 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 raised to 5 and 1 by 2 raised to 1, it is in the form of a raised to m into a raised to n, which we can write as what? 1 up, because here the base part is same. So this we can write as what? 1 by 2 raised to 5 plus 1 is 6. So 1 square, 1 raised to 6 is 1, and this will be 2 raised to 6, as we had done in the previous sum. Remember, when the base values is same and the power is different, apply the formula. Okay, remember, when the base is same, directly apply this indices formula to get the answer. Here clearly we can see that 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, it is same in the numerator also, cancel, so here we left with 1. Okay, so here into 1 raised to 6 is 1, 2 raised to 6 will be 2 raised to 6 only, and we know that as in the indices formula, any number raised to 0 is what? 1. So this 1 upon 2 raised to 0 will be what? 1 only. So here we left with what? 6 ones are 6 upon 2 raised to 6. Here it is 1, 2 raised to 6. Yes or no? Understood? Here clearly we can see that the denominator is same. So we'll write 1 time. And 6 plus 1 is what? 7. So 7 upon 2 raised to 6 is what? 2 raised to 6. It means we have to multiply 2 for 6 times. That means 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 for 6 times. So you will get the answer 64. And clearly we can see that we cannot cancel this number as here 7 and 64 even an odd number. So this one is the final step. And this 7 upon 64, it is the answer for P x greater than equals to 5. Okay. So probability of getting at least 5 odd number is equals to 7 by 64. So in this way you have to present your sum. Understood? Got the point? Okay, so now we'll see for the last one. So last one it was for at most 5. So now we'll find the answer for the at most 5. At most means what? At most 5 means what? X will be less than equals to 5. So when it says that less than equals to 5, so 5 will come 4, 3, 2, 1 up to 0. Okay, remember this. So p x less than equals to 5 means what? P of 0 will come, p of 1, p of 2, p of 3, p of 4, p of 5. So that means we have to apply the formula for how many times? 6 times. Okay, now for this part, for this particular sum, for at most 5, let's see, can we apply the shortcut formula? 1 minus p x, the negation of this will be what? Greater, and you will write 5. It means 1 minus greater than 5. Greater than 5 is what? 6, 7, 6, 7, 8, and then goes on. But up to, whenever it is at greater, yeah, at least greater or greater than equals to, see to it that up to where you will write, it depends on the value of n. So here the value of n is what? 6. So you will write up to 6. So x greater than 5, greater than 5, here we have 6, 7, 8, but it's all depend on n equals 2. So for this sum, n, the value of n is what? 6. So here only 6 will come. So we have to find p of 6 only. Understood? Now remember, as we saw in the previous sum, as we had applied the formula, shortcut formula, we saw we have to apply the binomial formula for 5 times. But when you will see for at most, here we clearly we can see that we have to find the formula, we have to apply the formula only for one time. If you stick with the regular method, this is known as regular method. This is what? A shortcut method. But that you have to guess for which particular type of the sum it will come. Okay, it is not compulsory that for each and every sum the shortcut will come. That you have to guess, as here clearly we saw that we cannot apply the shortcut here. But here, if you are applying the regular method, that means you have to apply the formula for 6 times. We have to find the value for p of 0, p of 1, p of 2, p of 3, p of 4, p of 5. Then you have to add all the numbers to get the answer for at most. Instead of that, instead of finding the value for p of 0, p of 1, p of 2, 3, 4, 5, simply find the answer for p of 6 and then subtract with 1. So now let's see. So here the formula is what? As we know that the formula is what? The formula is what? Formula is what? Ncx p raised to x q raised to n minus x. So n is what? N 6. C x here it is what? 6 into 1 by 2, that means p raised to x is what? 6 only. 1 by 2 raised to n minus x. So 1 minus 6 minus 6 means what? 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Again and again, I will not explain this part. You have to remember each and everything I had explained in the previous video. First go and watch that video and then come back and watch this video. Okay, without knowing the combination and the factorial, you cannot able to solve any sum from the exercise. Remember this. Okay, you must know how to solve the combination part. So remember each and everything I had explained in the previous video. So please go and watch that video first. Okay, again and again, I will not explain this part how to solve. So here this we can write as 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. This 1 upon 2 raised to 6. This 6 minus 6 is what? 0. So 1 minus. Clearly we can see that we can cancel this number. 1 into 1 raised to 6 is 1. 2 raised to 6 is 2 raised to 6. Any number raised to 0 is what? 1. So we left with 1 minus 1 ones are 1 by 2 raised to 6. So when you will cross this number, you will get 2 raised to 6 minus 1 upon 2 raised to 6. Yes or no? Understood? So 2 raised to 6, just now only we saw 2 raised to 6 is 64 minus 1 upon 64. So 64 minus 1 is what? 63 upon 64. Okay, so we cannot cancel this number. 3 and 4, that is odd and even number, so we cannot cancel. So this is the final step we can say. For at most 5. So this is the answer. So when you will see the backside answer will be 63 by 4 only. Okay, so in this way you have to present your sum in the board exam. Okay, remember the steps. See the presentation part. First you will start with let. See the target. As this sum, it was based on the odd numbers. That means you have to consider the odd numbers as successful trials and even number as the failure. Okay, so first you will write let, then you have to consider the p, whether it is odd number or even number, that you have to write. For coin also, head and tail. So that p you have to mention. P is what? Okay, whether it is head or it is tail. So it's all depend on the question. Okay. So you have to read the question carefully. Okay, then only you will come to know the particular values of how to find the value of n from the question, the value of x, and then p. And remember, while finding the value of p, no need of showing this 3-4 step, no need of writing the sample space n of a, event n of s, using the formula, no need of writing this all 3 step. Directly you can mention the value of p, then substitute the value of p in this formula to get the value of q. Then for each and every sum you will show this, you will write this 2 step. Then after that, after writing the formula, then only you will find the answer for given question. As here the first one it was for exactly, yes or no? The second one it was for at least, and the third one it was for at most. So here we completed with our first sum. As I hope you all understood the sum number 1. Yes or no? This one for at least, how to find the at least 5. And remember, this is known as regular method and this is known as a shortcut method, and you have to understand when we have to apply the shortcut method and when we have to use the regular method for at least and at the most. As here, I had got the answer with using the regular method. Here I got the answer by using the shortcut. If you apply the regular method also, still the answer will be same. 63 upon 64 only you will get when you will apply this method. You will get the same answer only. Okay. Understood? So in this way you will find your answer. So let's take one more sum.